All right, guys, the countdown is officially on to the Shaw Classic. I looked at the calendar and the weeks are going by quickly. I knew they were going by quickly, but we've really got to start dialing in the events at this point, doing better, coming at everything with a very, very high priority in training. So this week is exactly going to be that. We're going to start it off here today with some bag toss. We'll get into some leg training and get the week started right. Start to the week. Overall, pretty happy with how that went. Gonna have to dial in the bag toss event and really, really perfect everything I'm doing with that. But it's feeling better. Legs, definitely put some good work in there as well, and building up. So now I've got to hustle up as usual and get into a meeting. So much stuff going on right now. With the buildup, it's pretty much gonna be nonstop, but still maintain the priority on training because I have to be ready to compete alongside with organizing everything else. So I'm gonna go jump into that as usual, throw on a new shirt and make it happen.
All right, today we got a surprise for Brian. He does not know about this. So fingers crossed it turns out the way we imagined it to. And we're gonna get all set up and see Brian's reaction. Packaging maybe not the best. Here's the giant fan. All right, I'm gonna attempt to set this up. Fingers crossed. All right, if you're looking for a hint, here's the front. More importantly, you gotta have the back of the head grease. All right, so here we go. Oh, he's not blown up yet. And this is my friend Brian. He's gonna love it. I know he is. Hold on, get the whole angle before Brian come look at the crease on the back of his head. See, you gotta have that. We got Brian's socks, we got his Jordans-ish. So, my friend Brian is going to be greeting everyone at the Shaw Classic Expo. So you guys, Shaw Classic tank one. So make sure you guys come take a picture with him. But now we need to find Brian so we can surprise him with bigger Brian.
How awesome is that?
Is that so cool?
Okay, don't really hurt him. Oh no!
Okay.
Close your eyes.
All right, where am I going?
Come on!
All right. Oh, okay. Where am I going?
Open your eyes!
Oh, man. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
It's bigger than a real bag.
That's true. That is bigger than the real bag.
You
You think people at the Shaw Classic will like it?
We can punch it down at the Shaw Classic.
No, we're not gonna punch it down. We're gonna just wave. Say hi, Brian.
Hi, Dad. Hi, Dad.
It's the neck roll on the back.
Your favorite part of the whole thing. Of the whole thing is that. Got a little something.
Oh, that's meant to be there. It's like when you drop your food on you. That's what that is.
What? It's built into the design?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I don't have any right now, do I?
Did you just change your shirt to come out here right now?
Nope, I've stayed clean today.
I don't like it.
Log press, I feel like it's gone all right, but I'm gonna need to balance it out with how much chest press work coming up to the contest I'm gonna do versus overhead or incline work. So we'll play with that. Let's see how I feel after this first superset. And we'll rock it from there. Too many people in history that could walk over to the rack, grab the 200s, carry them to the bench, then lift them. So that is something I wanted to do today, and I don't know why that popped in my head, but it did, and it just happened. We are on the way to Red Iron now. They have finished up the handles and the seat belt on the leg press, so I'm just heading over there to see if they ended up in a good position and if they're gonna work. Hopefully they do work, and then we'll be able to go back and pick up the leg press and check that off the list officially of items that need to get done, because right now the equipment list is still very long, and if I'm being honest, it is definitely starting to stress me out quite a bit that we've got so much to get done, and I need a few things to just go right. So hopefully it does, and we're able to check it off, but we'll see here in a minute. Yo, yo.
Hey.
How's it going?
All right.
That'll go right. That's nice. There's plenty of room, that's good. I said there's plenty of room with the seatbelt there.
Yeah.
That's nice.
I don't think many guys are going to have it tighter than you.
Yeah. Maybe we can slide that pad over that seatbelt though. No, I think, it's kind of hard to 100% tell without some weight on there. You know what I'm saying? When I'm grabbing it, but yeah, I feel like I can grab and pull, which is...
Right.
The whole point of the handle
idea
is you walk in.
Your ass down in the crease, right?
And if I can grab and pull, then, you know, again, the other competitors, where if you go a little bit further back, if your arms are shorter or you're shorter, you know, but again, you know, it's only taking me an inch back and out, really. So, but it felt okay. I'm actually,
okay, good.
I mean, It's more so I want to get that pad on the seatbelt to make sure that's okay because, you know, that's huge. Because it kind of falls like right in there with that, where it clips together.
Or like just, one of those pool noodles would work.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is where you'd load them all in. And this lower part is going to be what's attached to your unit. So I've sort of kind of got a deal figured out to where you can just pull a chain and it'll release this one and it'll go down. You do your press and everything will advance. So when it's all done, said and done, and we want to load this back up to keep somebody from having to do it.
Grab each one, yeah.
They'll have enough space. This will lower down. This will have a stop on it. You'll open it up and they'll all just unload off of that one,
right
back onto this one, and then winch or whatever, however I figure it, it'll raise it back up into position to where it'll start loading this for the next competition.
That'll be awesome. So nobody has to touch anything. It'll just reset itself.
Well, you'll have to have somebody down there pull a lever to load the one deal. And then when it's back up there, you know, you'll have to have somebody, there'll be another lever which will open up and allow all the barrels to load it up.
I mean,
but they won't have to actually handle the barrels.
Sure.
It's just, you know, I hope I can make it work.
You make me
I'll
so
make
nervous.
Work, but
you make
I'm
me so
I'm
nervous when you say that.
You know, I told Dave, it's like, look, let's get this thing going now because
we have a lot of.
I'm gonna have to refigure some things that don't quite work like I'm thinking at the time.
Well, just like
I'll get real lucky. I might, you know, but
we need some luck. Well, I like luck. Luck with this would be awesome.
Yeah.
Too big to get through there. Cool. Get set up for a little bit of fingle finger today. Haven't hit that really since World's Strongest Man, so it'll be nice to dust it off and train it. So I'm gonna try to actually set it up as a medley today. So we'll go fingle finger and then run through the gym. And then go do power stairs in the back. So a little bit longer transition than we'll have at the contest, but the training effect should be good. So got a deadlift first, but always better to set the stuff up before you get rocking and rolling, before you get tired.
Hi.
Hey.
Can you do pictures in these today before training?
I definitely can.
Thank you.
That's exciting. Awesome.
Thanks.
Did you check out my form today?
Please go get to work.
I'm going. I just started taking my pre-workout.
Okay, love you, bye.
I don't know if you can tell.
Bye. Love you, bye.
Carrie always loves the forearm joke, as you guys can tell. Never, ever gets old. So this is exciting. This is the first drop of the Strongest Man on Earth shirts. If you did not check out the interview that I posted with Paul Ohl about the Strongest Man on Earth, please go check that out. So I don't have to explain as much, but I'm super excited that the Shaw Classic will be crowning the Strongest Man on Earth this year. So these shirts, this one is, man, that looks good. So this is the red on the black, just a black and white version of that one as well. And this is a green here, which came out good. I like that. This one is a tank top right here. And that's like a green and black. Actually, I really like that one. That's nice. So we've got to get some pictures up right now. And if you are watching this video, all of these shirts are now live, which is exciting. So really, really happy about how those came out and how all of this is coming together. But got to get the pictures done. We've got to get the training because the work still needs to get done.
Nope, just a couple straight on first.
Just look like forward.
Yeah, okay. Stare down above James's head.
Do you see him? Like, I literally...
Look how good this is.
I zone in.
This is a new women's t-shirt we went with. I think it actually fits really good too. You know me, I hate women's t-shirts and I love it. Yeah, I'm super excited.
Cool.
Okay, keep going.
All right, back in. Look. Look at this. Watch this transition. Ready?
Your face is wrinkled.
It's not.
It is.
It's not. Oh,
right there.
Okay.
Can you make me look small?
Yeah.
I feel like I do that.
You already do.
Oh, I know. I literally was just telling the people tell me in person, oh, you're bigger than I thought you were.
It's kind of.
I also get that as well. That makes you feel better.
No, it doesn't, because you want to be big. Me, they're they're like, oh, you're bigger than I thought you were.
It's probably not the best thing to say to a woman.
Brian still looks happier than I do. You were supposed to not smile.
Oh, do you want him more serious?
You want me to be serious?
Wait, the first one was smiling, I thought, and the second was not smiling.
He said less smile, so I toned back my smile.
Oh, hold on. I toned it down the whole way.
Okay, yeah, I'll tone it down.
We need like a 10% smile and like a...
Okay, zero.
This.
Yeah.
that face.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Awkward. Ooh. Awkward child smile. Go.
I don't even know what that means. Your arms look kind of small.
You hear that fucking... Kind of small.
Okay. I just snorted.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
And then close up. And then...
I was way not serious for that.
I'm so excited. I'm going to order more women's clothing now.
In the sun. All right, where do I sign so I don't make it all wet?
Just here, spot.
Cool.
Thank you. Are you doing more?
I've got a little bit.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Yeah. This is progress. I'm very impressed.
Oh, with the progress?
Amazing, man.
Yeah.
Wow, that looks
the
great.
The first two big hoops that he had
were
rolled right on.
Okay.
These ones ain't.
Oh, no.
I'm going to have to.
So did you only have to mess with that center?
As far as how deformed it was,
Nice.
I got those. These I'm just gonna have to spread out a little bit. That's what I'm doing, digging down over there.
Nice.
Porta power, so.
God, that looks already, looks cool, man. You think if I back the trailer up?
Yeah, if you get back the trailer actually in it, then I can just set it on there with this.
Right. Maybe we'll try to do that real quick.
I'll give you some more leverage.
Ours are the exact same, and we had them at 21, so we're lowered an inch, make them heavier.
Okay, so we're doing an 8-inch diameter pipe?
Okay. And this is the thickness. We just measured.
And you want 18 foot from the hole that it pivots on, or you want 18 foot total, and then I come up like 4 inches and put the hole in for the pivot?
I think total. Total. Okay. Yeah. The problem is you can't, if it's light enough where you can do more than eight reps with the load, it's
tire out anyhow because it's just too much. So I think leaving it at 8 is fine.
And we might only load 7 in, I don't know.
Do you want me to send them out for powder coat and get them powder coated red, white, and blue?
Let me ask the sponsor of the event, because we talked to them about, you know, putting some type of decal on it or sticker. Mm-hmm. So,
all right, just
red, white, and blue would be sick, though.
You cannot make any decisions on powder coat within the 2 weeks of the contest. You will not get it done.
Okay, so we need to make that call now.
You have about, well, from yesterday, you had 3 weeks.
Okay.
So like refreshing.
Yeah.
To meet someone that's like, it's not about him. Like it's about the sport and like people before him, people after him, which is so cool.
See, and that's what I mean, and that not many people will understand this, but that's what I got to experience.
Yeah.
In 2009.
At Fort Tishman.
Yeah.
Yep.
Just going there, you could tell. You could just tell, and you know the
like
brief.
Feel it, you mean?
Yeah, the brief conversation, but it was just the way that it was organized, the way that it was ran, you know, all of that was so good back then, and it's so
he
neat to.
So amazing.
Yeah,
just
he's
so,
a very,
like inspiring. Like that's just so cool.
Yeah, he's a really, really, really good dude. So, yeah, it's, now I feel even more. I don't want to say pressure. I feel like pressure, but it is. Like he said, it's a heavy burden.
Yeah.
It really is. It's a heavy burden to have to carry. You know,
it
it's
definitely
not,
kind of takes it to another level. You kind of think like, hey, I'm trying to do my best to put on a really good event and give back to the athletes. But to hear someone of his magnitude and his experience to say, hey, Brian, I'm passing the torch to you, buddy. It's your turn.
Yeah. Well, you got to pick it up and run.
Makes me want to work harder.
Yeah. Up in the mountain gym for some event training today. We got a beautiful day. We also have the documentary crew in as well, so we'll get a little bit of behind the scenes going on there. That's a documentary that I am self-funding. It's the Brian Shaw story, so I know some of you have been asking about that because you've seen little snippets and videos or pictures, things like that, but we're coming to the finish line. Hopefully we'll finish that up at the Shaw Classic this year, so really excited about that project. But the deadline is coming for the contest, and event training needs to happen. I've got to stay on point with where I'm going, bring a great package to the contest this year. That's the goal. So we're going to jump into it. And even though they're here, I've got to be very serious about my training and knock it out.
Oh.
pounds is it?
How much pounds is it? A lot. A lot, a lot. Good. Get it now. Come on. Attack. Like you're in second place. Let's go.
You want to win?
That was better than the set before.
Yeah,
attacked. Equally as fast with a heavier bag. Attacked it a little bit better. Guys, finishing up. Good week of training overall. Definitely the countdown is on. And every training session at this point is critical. I got to stay focused, stay dialed in. The stress of putting on the event is certainly going up. But we got to keep checking things off the list. Getting closer and closer, and I can't lose focus with my training and my prep going into my last contest here. So we're gonna make it happen. Beautiful day, good energy in the gym today, loving it. Definitely loving every minute of this going into my last contest. And yeah, I'm tired and it's time to eat. We're gonna end it there. So hope you all are doing amazing. For now, go out and be great. We'll check you guys next.